Hey, what's up guys, Pablo Munoz here. Welcome to a brand new tutorial series where I'm gonna cover my entire workflow using the ZBrush Face Tool plugin. So this is a fantastic plugin that you can download from the Reolution website, and basically it connects ZBrush with Character Creator 4 so that you can create and customize and tweak all the expressions for your characters, including the wrinkle maps and all sorts of really cool stuff. It's really easy to install and the workflow is very, very simple. So I'm gonna cover everything from scratch. We're gonna build all the expressions and all the wrinkles from scratch in a brand new character, so you can follow along and create your own character that will have expressions and wrinkles and all of that. So it's gonna be really, really fun. Let's go ahead and jump straight into it. All right, so this first video in the series is all about the setup and the research that you probably have to do if you wanna get something that works really well with this plugin and this whole workflow that I'm gonna show you. So what I have here is a pretty generic face. This is actually from Character Creator 4. You see, it is just a face, but this actually comes with the body as well. And by the way, I'm in ZBrush 2024 at the moment, and I'm using a custom UI. The UI doesn't really matter. In fact, I'm just gonna go ahead and change it for the standard UI so that you are more familiar with what I'm gonna be using here. So this is the standard UI, right? And I'm just gonna go ahead and double click on these arrows right here on the left-hand side. And I'm gonna click on this icon right here just to remove any palette. And I'm gonna bring in the C plugin palette. So after you install the plugin called the ZBrush Face Tools, this is what you will see here. Right? So again, it's very, very simple, very easy to use. I'm gonna cover all of these, don't worry. It might look a little bit daunting at the moment, but it's very, very simple. It's just a series of switches that turn on and off things that are already part of ZBrush. So what I wanna do in this video is just cover kind of like the setup on how you can create the starting point of your project and how to think about the expressions and the wrinkles that we're gonna be creating in the following videos. So yeah, like I said, what I have here is a pretty generic face, and I have this texture map that sort of like corresponds to the areas of the face and the muscles, let's say, that when you have an expression, it was going to pull them. So this area right here that creates the crease around the nose and the mouth when you smile, this is the line that is gonna be pulled and create that crease. So you see it's a slightly thicker line here. So this is very important because the way that you push and pull the geometry, that's gonna impact the way that Character Creator reads that topology to deform the mesh. So in other words, just so that we don't complicate things too much, in order to get a really good wrinkle system and expressions in Character Creator 4, we need to think about the topology and the flow of the topology that we have underneath. Fortunately, we're gonna be using the base mesh on Character Creator 4, and all this topology is ready to go. We just need to think about these colors, right? These patches of colors that you see here. Don't worry, I'm gonna cover all of that in just a second. I wanna make sure that I cover everything right. So let's jump into CC4, Character Creator 4. And from now on, I'll probably just refer to Character Creator 4 as CC4, just so that you know, just because it's a little bit faster to say it. So this character right here, or this head, is exactly the same thing that I have here in ZBrush. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna turn on the same sort of map. You don't have to do this. This is just purely to give you a reference of what we're gonna be doing. So right now we have exactly the same thing that we have in ZBrush in terms of the map. And you see everything fits nicely into this face. Now, the reason why this is so important when we're thinking about expressions and wrinkles and all of that is because the rig that comes with Character Creator 4 is going to use this topology to deform and create the expressions. So let's go ahead and jump into this tab right here and click on the Edit Facial. And this is gonna give us a really nice and simple control that we can use to edit the expressions of the face. So let's just make this guy smile by clicking on these two, these two portions of the map, of the face map, and with the middle mouse button, you can push this up. So you see what this is doing, right? It's pushing those polygons, right? That topology upwards. And if we get closer here, you see this is the line that I was talking about that is quite thick. So this is going to create that nice sort of like crevice that it's formed when we smile, right? The same thing, if we just go ahead and push this down towards the bottom, you see this is the corner of the mouth, and here, in this sort of like purpley area, that is creating that kind of like bulging, exaggerated wrinkle here. So all of this is very important to keep in mind when you're creating expressions. Let's have a look at a different one. I'm gonna reset this back to the neutral pose, and I'm gonna click on all these portions here for another expression. Let's say when I create surprise, I'm gonna press, pull this out. And don't worry too much about the texture that is appearing here. This is purely because as I move this, Character Creator is actually grabbing the portion of these wrinkles with the texture and everything else. So it looks pretty cool. But if I just push it down, it will just disappear. The same thing if I push it down a little bit, you'll see it gets those really nice wrinkles. Anyway, the point here is that in order to get this really cool set of wrinkles that are dynamic as we move and change the expression of our character, we need to think in terms of the topology. So you see, for this area, for the eyebrows, we're going to concentrate on this kind of like bluish area of the polygons, right? So when we move, let's say, this portion right here, we're not actually touching any of the other colors, if you will, of the topology, right? And this is just a texture map that I'm using as a reference. You don't have to have this on or anything like that. We're gonna keep things very practical. This is, like I said, just giving you the understanding of what we need to aim for. All right, so let's go ahead and reset this back to zero. And actually, I wanna clear everything out and make this guy smile again, right? All right, so with this brief intro out of the way, the first step for this project is to actually collect the references that we're going to use to produce the wrinkles and the expression for our character. And it could be any humanoid character. It could be stylized. It could be more realistic. It could be absolutely anything that you want. The workflow that I'm going to show you and the steps that we're going to follow are applicable to any type of humanoid character that you want to create with expressions. So to collect references, what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring in PureRef, which is this software right here that I'm having here floating on top of the window. It is a very simple free software that you can download, and it's very simple to use. So I'm not going to spend too much time talking about PureRef necessarily, but this is basically what I have here. I'm also going to bring in Pinterest, which is what I have in here. And as you can see, let's move this out of the way. I just search for expressions. So I have all of these expressions that I found like really, really interesting. And what I like to do when I'm collecting references is to take this window and put it to the left. And let's bring in PureRef, put it to the right-hand side. There we go. And as I search for different expressions, I'm going to, let's say, click and drag this image from Joaquin Phoenix, this one from Willem Dafoe. This is an awesome set of expressions in here. This one from George Clooney, Pascal as well, Pedro Pascal. I think this is Mark Wahlberg. Anyway, you get the idea. There's a bunch of different expressions. So for instance, this one, it could be a really good reference for, you know, if you look at it, you know, half, let's push this kind of like half of the screen. Hopefully you can see that. This could be a really good reference for like frowning. And if I move it to the other side, it could be a good reference for kind of like an evil expression or something like that. So I'm just going to go ahead and do that. This is a great one for smiling. And what I would recommend is that if you search for a specific expressions of an actor, for example, this Gordon Joseph Levitt, I think that's his name. This type of reference is really good because it shows a great range of different emotions and different expressions, but it's of the same person. So that way you will have a more consistent representation of the different wrinkles. So these ones are really, really good. So this one for Henry Cavill, let's say, it's not a great range in here. So probably this one is not the best one. Right, so obviously this is a very boring process for you to just watch me collecting references. So what I've done is already collected my references, but I just want to show you very quickly that once you've done this, and you know it could be 100 different references, what you can do is start grouping them together into different expressions, and that way it allows you to refer back to your board of references for a specific you know expression. So for instance, let's say this could be anger or like evil. Laugh or something. So I could just copy and paste this. So Control C, Control V in PureRef, holding the C key, and I'm going to crop this one right here. So this could be one that could also go along with this one right here, and maybe this one, maybe this one as well. So copy, paste just to duplicate it, pressing the letter C and crop this region right here. So I'm just going to create these little clusters of different expressions. Anyway, I'm not going to spend too much time on it. Just want to show you that this is kind of like the next step in terms of collecting references. I want to select all these four and press the Control, Alt, and the left arrow key so that they're all the same sort of width. And then press the Control P to pack, right? So this is a really good way of collecting references. All right, so I'm going to show you the final board that I created. So you have a better understanding of, once you go through this process, what it would look like. So let's go ahead and close this up. And I'm going to close this, and I'm not going to save it. And here is my board. All right, so I'm going to enter in full screen just to show you what I've done here. So I've just kind of like grouped all my references together, and I'm going to walk you through what I have here. And ideally, you want to do the same thing regardless of the project that you're trying to do. So what I have here, these are just, you know, various references of different actors mainly that have like really good range of expressions, and especially with the eyebrow region. So, you know, just a bunch of like really cool expressions that I can refer back to when I'm doing a specific one, right? So I can get this one, for instance, as a surprise and look at the different wrinkles that are formed in this area. And then I can also look at, you know, something else, let's say, George Clooney, this one. So I can compare like the different wrinkles that are generated depending on the age as well, the age difference. So yeah, this is just a general reference board for the different expressions that I'm going to make. Now, the one that I have here is just a stylization reference. So when you look at these references, even though they are human characters, they're very stylized and they have very very specific features around their faces. So I think this is actually a render, so you can ignore that one, but it might be a real person. No, this is a render, so you can ignore that one. So the rest, you know, they have very particular things that I might want to incorporate in the design of my character. Even if I want to try to do something stylized or realistic, I will look for this type of references to try to convey the same idea in my concept. So, you know, maybe this type of curvature here for the nose, this very pronounced areas or wrinkles around the face, or the very thick and big cheekbones. It would be like something that I would extract from this reference as well. You know, this, to me, the difference between these two persons, like the eyes are close together in this case, but this one are kind of like droopy and far apart. So these are the type of things that I'm going to look into incorporating, at least into my design, you know, proportions as well. So I have this old man here that have like really large ears, you know, in proportion with the rest of the face, a very, very wide smile as well. So these type of things are the what I'm referring to as the stylization reference. It doesn't have to be a cartoony or stylized character. It could be a real person that has like very exaggerated features, and then you can extract that or put it into your reference. Now, the next set of clusters of this reference are kind of like the main three expressions that I want to create in this tutorial series. So I'm going to concentrate on one mainly, but I'm going to cover the rest of the expression. So for instance, this angry expression, I just collected a bunch of references that express that anger. And one of the things that is very particular about this type of expression is the platysma, this sort of like neck region. Right here, it gets all tensed up. So this is something that I will definitely have to include in the expression. And you know, there are some references that have like the open mouth or the open jaw, other ones that are like kind of like, you know, grinding their teeth like that. But all of these, in a way, are different variations of the same expression. So what I can do with this reference is try to extract certain things that I can replicate in my made-up character, whatever that is, to create this expression. Now, just very quickly, I have the same thing for surprise and fear, and this evil laugh and smile. And I think just, you know, I think William Dafoe would be probably the best reference for this type of character or for this type of expression. All right, so that's pretty much it. Now, apart from that, and this is something that you can do if you want to, I would advise you do it, but you don't have to. It's just to do a quick sketch of the different expressions that you want to achieve. So I just did a very rough outline with a, you know, kind of like the character that I want to recreate. I don't have anything particular in mind, but this is kind of like the character that I want to recreate. And yeah, so I have this anger expression, this surprise, and this, you know, evil laugh. I mean, it's not great, but what I wanted to do with these references is just to outline the main lines of the face and the main wrinkles of the face that are formed with a particular expression. So, you know, I'm concentrated on the eyebrow region, as well as the nose and mouth, right, for all of this. So you don't have to do this, but I would recommend you do it if you can. Now, the final thing, just to wrap up this introduction to this project, is the following. And this is something that I would highly recommend you do before you jump into anything else. So this is the face that I have here in Character Creator 4. Let's move this out of the way. So this is the face. Let's actually go back to zero. And don't worry, I'm going to show you how to set everything up in the next video. But let's say once you have your base mesh or your generic face, before you start tweaking the character that you want to create, what you can do is take a screenshot of this neutral face, pretty much what I have in here, right? And then use this controller to create a couple of expressions. Let's say a smiling expression or an angry expression, that sort of thing. So screenshot that as well. And let's go back in here. So this is what I have. All right. So I have a neutral expression and I have this smile expression with this sort of like reference of the different colors. Now, I took from my reference board, I took this guy because I think it has a very good set of expressions. And if I were to replicate something like that, it'll be a little bit tricky because of the proportions and the placement of the topology. So I took that that photo. And what I've tried to do here is to map the different colors of the topology that I mentioned and the loops around the face of this character. You see, if I put this next to this character, or like the generic face in here, you see it is very different in terms of, you know, the proportions and all of that, but I kind of like follow the same principle of the topology. So I have this slightly darker purple coming around here from the nose all the way to the chin. So that's what I have in here. Right? Same thing, let's say for the lips, they're kind of red, so I just added in here. And obviously the lips of this person is not as pronounced, or they're not as, you know, big as the reference. But this is something that I found to be really useful, and I think it's very important that you do this with whatever reference you have. And I would encourage you to do it with, you know, 3 or 4 or even 5 different photos in your reference board so that you understand where to map these areas or how to apply, let's say, the loop around the eyebrows in your character or in your reference. And it's a good practice. You don't have to do it in order to follow along with this tutorial, but I would recommend it because it would make your life a lot easier when we get to actually adjust these expressions in ZBrush. All right, so I'm going to leave this lengthy introduction to the project here. And in the next video, we're going to actually set up the project, send things to ZBrush, and start playing around with this awesome tool. All right, I'll see you there.